colored capsicums plus fish equals aquaponics. What is aquaponics?
In this episode, we share with you how we are raising tasty fish and getting a bumper harvest of colored capsicums on the same farm system. Twende kazi. This farm is located in the beautiful valleys of Muranga County next to River Sagana. Apart from the aquaponic system, we have chicken, goats, and even a cat that keeps the rodents away. We also grow mangoes and pawpaws as well. In our crop production unit, we have a vertical tower system growing spring onions, coupled with two troughs growing kales, broccoli, and cauliflower. On the other side, we have 8 troughs of colored capsicums, 4 red and 4 yellow.
When you pay us a visit, we get to show you, you know, depending on gender, male or female, which is the sweetest. How do you tell which is the male capsicum and the female capsicum? So more of that during our training sessions.
In the fish ponds, we are rearing tilapia and catfish.
This is what we call tilapia fish, freshwater fish, as you can see. And the difference between tilapia and catfish is like day and night. You can see even the catfish has some whiskers. Yeah, and it's quite fleshy, does not have, you know, a lot of bones like tilapia, and is best used for fish fillet. So, yeah, so this is catfish.
Now to the important question, what is aquaponics?
Aquaponics is just the merging of two types of farming, fish farming and vegetable farming. So basically in aquaponics we combine the farming of fish, which is normally called aquaculture, and hydroponics, which is the farming of vegetables without using soil. So how does that work? Basically the water coming from the fish pond provides nutrients to the crops, so the crops depend on the fish for nutrients. And as the water comes into the troughs, as you can see here, or onto the vertical pipes, as you can see with the spring onions and other vegetables, the water is filtered. The excess ammonia from the fish poop, the excess fish feed in the water is brought and pumped here into the troughs, and then basically the crops get that manure and all those nutrients. And as the water goes back to the fish, the water is cleaner, and also the plant roots inject oxygen into the water. So basically there is more oxygenation of the water going back to the fish. And basically that's what the fish require, that the water is clean and has a lot of oxygen. So why aquaponics? Number one is that aquaculture has a lot of water wastage. You can expect to be doing a water change. The ponds, such as the ones you have seen being operated in this farm, each pond has 60,000 liters of water, and there are 10 ponds. So you can imagine, for just doing a water changeover of 60,000 liters is a lot of water. And, you know, just offloading that water out and then getting in fresh water, it means a lot of energy input, So basically, even if you're going for solar, you'll need a lot of panels to sustain that changeover. But in aquaponics, there is no changing of water. So basically, you're using the same water from the fish pond and circulating it into the crop system. And then the crops clean out the water for you. That is one. Number two is that at the end of the day, you'll have a good cash flow from both the crops and the fish. So it's kind of integrated. So you can expect to start harvesting the crops 3 months after transplanting, and then the fish, such as the tilapia fish you've seen me holding, is just 6 months old. The third point is that, unlike hydroponics, aquaponics is more pH tolerant. So basically what you have is that due to the excess ammonia coming from the fish, you'll find the pH fluctuating between 6.8 to 7.0. But as you will notice from a closer look at the colored capsicums, you'll realize that there is less nutrient deficiency. Hydroponics is quite pH sensitive, 5.5 to 6.5 generally for all crops grown hydroponically, and 5.8 to 6.0 for flowering and fruiting crops. So basically, it's a very small margin of error. But an aquaponic system is able to absorb, you know, a difference of one from 5.8 to 6.8. And still you have a system that is running well. Finally is the management of costs. In hydroponics, the cost of nutrients per month for such a structure will be Kenya shillings 6,000 or 60 USD, compared to fish feed that is enough for fish that can sustain this particular unit, measuring 8 meter by 24 meters, you will only need 20 US dollars or 2,000 Kenya shillings. So basically, it is cheaper in the long run to have an aquaponic system.
It's been a busy 4 months of proper feeding, disease, and pest management. From transplanting through the growing stage to flowering, fruiting, and today, we are harvesting our first fruits.
If managed properly, this aquaponic system will provide a constant flow of sustainable income.
For step-by-step classes on how to fully operate an aquaponic system, talk to us via our email, grandeurafrica@gmail.com. We also offer consultation and off-taking services where we walk the journey with you from transplanting to harvesting. Judging from the yield in kilograms today, the next 6 months of harvesting look very promising. For more videos on farming in Africa, subscribe to our channel. Till next time, have a good one.